Hello everyone, and welcome to what should turn out to be the final installment of Let's Play Deus Ex Human Revolution. Last time, when I left off, I had just arrived at Panchaea, so let's pick it up there. Chapter 15, Tipping Point. Several days after slipping aboard a bell tower ship, Jensen arrived at a remote laboratory complex in Singapore. Seraph scientists were there, forced to create a unique biochip that could prevent people from using their augmented abilities. But millionaire Hugh Darrow, owner of the complex and willing participant in the Illuminati plan, had a different use in mind. Convinced that augmentations would be the death of mankind, Darrow used the chip to drive augmented people insane, setting off a horrific chain of events that only Jensen can end. Anyway, this is not my save from the beginning. I don't quite know where that came from. Let's just load up the earlier permasave. I explored around a little bit and, you know, just looked for things.
Jensen, can you read me?
Barely. I've reached Panchaea, Pritchard. Any word from Seraph or the UN delegates?
Nothing. The installation went into lockdown shortly after Darrow gave his speech. I can't tell if anyone's even alive. And the signal's still broadcasting.
Meaning no one's safe till I get in there and shut it down.
You'll have to disengage the lockdown first. Look for a master control panel at the top of the tower.
Alright, get inside the tower and disengage the lockdown, shutting down Darrow's signal. According to Pritchard, Panchaea activated emergency protocols sometime after Darrow's signal went live. I won't be able to descend through the station unless I manually disengage the lockdown. To do that, I'll have to go up. The master control panel is at the top of the tower. Anyway, I just tried to hop down onto that ice, but that wasn't happening. So, we have a UK helicopter here, a Japanese one here, a Canadian one here. All nicely indicative that a global summit was taking place when Darrow started getting up to his shenanigans. That really looked like a mind template for a second, and absolutely threw me off. Anyway, there's almost no danger for a while. The danger doesn't really start until after we terminate the lockdown. So anyway, I hop up in this box, I discover a plasma rifle and some shotgun cartridges, and two plasma capsules. That's nice. Let's keep poking around. Nothing in this one. What a shame. Hard to tell what country that's from. Or maybe that's a native Panchaea chopper. That's what it looks like. Looks like there's one more unexplored container over here, which has two credit chips, 25 and 50. Although I don't really have a use for more credits, believe it or not, we do have one more opportunity to spend some credits before the end of the game. There are two boxes of heavy rifle ammo here. I'm gonna go down there in a minute. Let's poke around over here first. So there's no direct way in. No admittance, authorized personnel only, and this door's disabled. We can't get in through there either. My target is that open vent up there. That's not my ultimate entrance, but I have to head in there to get some skill points. If I pop in here, hey look, beers. Let's make up the 6 HP we lost in at the end of the Omega Ranch. Hefekraken. Yeah, we've seen that already. Oh, I didn't want to drop it. I wanted to drink it. Anyway, we've got another credit chip in here. 75 credits. Plus a bottle of painkillers. Alright, let's start hopping up these containers now. There's another open one here. We go inside, we find a PEPS energy pack and a laser rifle battery. We also find sniper rifle ammo and a Cyber Boost Pro energy bar. All of that is actually pretty useful. Finally, we keep hopping up, we find one more we can explore. It's got a weapon cabinet which contains a gas grenade and three combat rifles. And it's got an ammo case with 10 combat rifle ammo and 5 shotgun cartridges. That. Let's hop up here. Hop into the vent. Get 300 XP. as soon as you pop in here. Let me just show you where this pops out, and then when we get to the other side of that exit. So, as you can see, we're at the very top of this room with an inactive box guard. Let's go back out and let's take that open corridor we found. Might as well stun, just because I think it's neat and I never really get an opportunity to use it. Now, all of the enemies that we'll eventually meet in here are the same sort of crazies we saw at the end of the Omega Ranch. They aren't worth any combat XP, so we can just sneak past them or do single takedowns as long as we're undetected, whatever we want to do. The important thing to note, though, is that there are stealth bonuses in Panchaea, so we do have to stay undetected. Anyway, let's creep up here along this pipe and get both of the EMP grenades lining this hallway. Then I'll get down and check the hallway itself. I think there's one dead body down there. Of course, we don't have to worry about the electricity, thanks to our EMP shielding augmentation. Anyway, the body has a Peps energy pack on it. That's always handy, but not much else going on. Anyway, we'll hop up here. I'll turn right first. There's another dead body. He's got a mine template, so I'll go ahead and make an EMP mine. My favorite flavor. As we move down this hallway, yes, there is a frag mine on the wall over here, and several more dead bodies. Let's go ahead and grab the frag mine. That dead body has 10 credit chip. Credit chip with, or 10 credits, 15 credits, 10 credits. When we get into this room, we get 200 XP explorer bonus. This room has grenade launcher ammo and a grenade launcher. The dead body has 250 credits and 20 heavy rifle ammo, plus a heavy rifle lying on the ground next to it. Over in the corner, we have shotgun cartridges. And that's really it for this room. We mainly came there for the experience, but there are plenty of goodies in there, too. Next, we'll go this way. And if I remember correctly, there's at least one more mine to worry about. Yes, it's up in that ventilation shaft. Just a moment, folks. I apologize. And we're back. I apologize for the little hiccup. Let's just keep on rolling over here. Now, this is a little bit tough. Kind of want to... Oh, there we go. If you do it just right, you can skip up onto the pipes without blowing the mine and then disarm it. That vent, I believe, will become my ultimate exit from here. Well, let me check exactly where this bad boy goes. Oh hey, look here. There's another mine over here. So let's creep up on it. Very carefully, of course. Right. Yes, and then we find ourselves in this room, but I prefer to come in through the door because there's hacking involved, so... Now the big question is how to land back in the vent. on, Jensen. You can do it. I know you can. Well, maybe not. I think he needs to be standing at his full height and need to... Dang it. Well, I hope I didn't, I hope my last quick save was before dropping into the room. And it was. Okay, good. Yeah, we don't want to miss the hack on the door. But if you've gotten this far without getting your level 4 capture software, you can still get into that room. We, of course, hack everything. Because experience points are awesome. Anyway, there's another frag mine to be careful of up here on the wall. Right before we finally get out of this water. Disarm it and pick it up. Now that ladder is our ultimate way out, but let's head down around this corner and hack open this door. Level 4. But we can get to the server node, which always means all is well.
Access granted.
200 XP plus 100 for the hack. Now, here we are back in this room. The dead body has a stop worm software and 120 credits on it. In the corner, we find a Peps and a Peps energy pack. And there's the breaker box we can use to deactivate the electricity in the water. Now, let's hop up here. And we find ourselves on the other side of this giant dysfunctional door. There's a laser rifle battery over there. And not too much else. Here's the other side of that disabled door. Why there are Seraph Industries boxes, I don't really know. But we'll just head up these stairs. Now, over there is the elevator to the tower section. We don't want to go there yet. We want to clear out the entry hall first. So on this cart, there are two boxes of heavy rifle ammo. Otherwise, not really anything going on here. Hack that computer in a bit. Looks like I'll explore that vent in a little bit. Same with this vent. This ammo crate has 30 combat rifle ammo and 5 revolver ammo in it. Now there is the inactive box guard. Now we need to destroy it, but what we have to be careful of is if it blows up right here in its default spot, that camera will explode and we will lose a smooth operator bonus. So before I get too involved with any of the other stuff, let me go through this door where there's machine pistol ammo. Here's where we came down those stairs. And here in the corner is a security hub. Level 5. I'm gonna go ahead and hack it. Cannot get to... There are 2 server nodes and I cannot get to both. So... I'm just gonna unlock everything I can. And we're fine.
Access granted.
500 XP plus 125 for the base hack. And now there's only the one camera, but I can turn on the robot, which I'll do since there are no active enemies in here anyway. All right.
Enter combat.
See if that'll do the trick. No, it won't. That has set off the alarm. I need to make the thing move. So how do we do that? I don't know. Can I move a box guard around with pistol shots the same way I could a human guard? Nope. Not doing much. Well, maybe I need to set it to default. And then, since it wants to hurt me at that point, I'll be able to lure it away from the camera.
Enter combat.
Alright. Now that I've put a little bit of distance between it and the camera, I'll disable it.
Activate self-destruct sequence.
Let me see if that was sufficient. Yes, the camera was spared. Good. Now we've got the box guard handled. Now let me go over to this computer. I said I'd hack it, but I lied. It's unlocked. From Hiren Alpha at Panchaea.consortium.net to Sex Center Command at Panchaea.consortium.net. Mercury Insta Messaging Autosave. This conversation was automatically saved in your conversation history. Hiren Alpha Pod. Panchaea Oceanic Installation 5 online. Emergency situation detected. We/us have detected major power fluctuation / pressure instability / outages / malfunctions across wide areas of the Oceanic Station. Repeated alert warnings remain unattended. Situation approaching critical. Advise. Sec Control Command or Sec Central Command unresponsive. Analysis suggests immediate activation of emergency lockdown procedure 999 is necessary. Commencing full station lockdown in 5, 4, 3, 2. Emergency override protocols activated. To disengage lockdown, proceed to main tower and use manual override 747736. Have a nice day. From Hiren Alpha at Panchaea.consortium.net to all staff at Panchaea.consortium.net. This is not a test. Attention all staff, the Panchaea Oceanic Installation 5 is experiencing a temporary emergency lockdown situation. This is not a test. No one may enter or exit the facility while the lockdown safety measure is in effect. All movement between sectors is likewise prohibited. Panchaea security response teams have been notified and mobilized. Please remain at your workstations while the lockdown is in effect. Security staff will alert you when it is safe to resume normal work activities. This is an automatically generated message from the Panchaea Oceanic Installation 5 Hiren Core. I see it, Mommy. That's odd and creepy. Anyway, let's poke around some vents now. 100 XP for exploring that one. If we go over here, get another 100 XP. Spits us out right at the bottom of another staircase. There's an unhackable door. Before I mess with the storage room, let's go ahead and check the... Those two hackable doors go into the same area. Let's go poke around the top level first. Let's get a message here.
Pritchard, Panchaea's broadcast center is at the base of the station near the bottom of the ocean. Is that right?
But the lockdown caused all the blast doors to seal. You won't be able to go down until you override them manually.
From up in the tower. I got it.
Okay, so that's just a reminder. That's the door that will eventually take us down to the ring section. Let's explore these vents up here. You saw that opening on the left. I'll go there just as soon as I make sure there's nothing else I need. Oh, we can go up another level in here. So let's do that. Climb even higher. Go over to the window. Move along it. Somewhere in here, the XP bonus should register. I'm having trouble finding it. It's in here somewhere. I know that. Yeah, there's a 100 XP bonus. There it is. It's kind of hard to track down, but... 100 XP traveler bonus for getting up to this hidden top level. We find a dead body here next to a rocket launcher. The body itself has 250 credits. And as we creep out here, we find ourselves at the exit from the vent we were in earlier. Now that we're down here, let's hack these two doors. Two pretty basic level 3 hacks. We can go straight to the server node. Gonna nuke that level 6 directory.
Access granted.
A nuke virus and 75 XP. The door is unlocked. Let's go hack the other one. Cannot go to the server node. There's a data store over here. And then the exit node right over here.
Access granted.
Got a stop worm and 75 XP. 200 XP explore bonus for coming in here, which gives me the second to last experience based praxis point I'll need. Go ahead and get Mark and Track 2.0. And call it good. In here, there are shotgun cartridges, a shotgun, and grenade launcher ammo. And in the other room, where we could have popped out the vent shaft. Oh, wait. This is a completely different vent. Where does this one go? Okay, that's handy. Just hop back down. This storage room has rockets in it. With all that, we are ready to go take the elevator up to the tower section. So let me head that way. pretty lengthy elevator ride, I have to say. Alright, now we're out here. Let's explore the hallway first. The first locker has a Peps energy pack and stun gun darts. The second locker has a bottle of painkillers. There's one entrance into a cafeteria. Let me go check around this hallway. That dead body has nothing. This dead body has nothing. There's another entrance into the cafeteria. This dead body has nothing. In this vent, which doesn't go anywhere, the dead body itself has nothing, but there's a pocket secretary next to its hand. No subject, from blank to blank. This message has not yet been sent. Doug, I am witnessing the most disturbing things I have ever seen. Something terrible is happening here. Panchaea has erupted into complete mayhem. Augmented workers are running amok, writhing in pain, and senselessly attacking everything in their path. I do not know what is going on, but it appears their augments are turning against them. I can see several afflicted people nearby. Soldiers, I think, from the... And the spelling is very bad, and the message cuts off. Well, now you can see... On the other side of that wall, there's an active person, so need to be careful. That dead body has nothing. This door can't be opened. We've got a storage room here, but before that, here's the last entrance to the cafeteria. So let's go ahead and check it out. That dead body has nothing. This table has nothing, and neither do any of the benches. This dead body has nothing. Neither does this table. Or any of the benches. So we go over to the bar. We find nothing. The dead body has nothing on it either. But here, on the ground, is a Cyber Boost Pro Energy Jar, which is handy. Now, let's head into this storage room. Just have to keep quiet enough not to alert our muttering friend in the next room. Doesn't appear to be anything useful in here, but we can move that refrigerator and open up this vent, which will allow us to crawl over to the room he's in. I know. We get a 200 XP exploration bonus for getting in here. Go in. And we'll give our crazed friend the old punch-punch treatment. He's got nothing, but the room has a Cyber Boost Pro Energy bar, two plasma capsules, a Peps, grenade launcher ammo. The dead body has nothing. Under the desk is a Peps energy pack. On the desk, there is a pocket secretary. Temporary living quarters, from admin at panchaea.consortium.net to trudeau.exec.assistant, ASST at thehill.gc.ca.gov. Ms. Lapikas, for the duration of the summit, the door code to Mrs. Trudeau's temporary dressing room will be 8024. Please try to explain to both the Prime Minister and his wife that Panchaea is still under construction, so she shouldn't be expecting something akin to that Chateau Laurier luxury suite she's grown so accustomed to in Ottawa, especially given how little time we've had to prepare for this summit. Thank you. The computer is unlocked, and it contains two emails we've already read. So, let's head back out here. Back out into the main hallway. And let's keep going. This is now really the only open path. And here's a disabled door. Here's an unlocked door to a bathroom. Nothing at the sink, nothing at the first stall, nothing at the second stall. In the back, there's one stopworm software. Here on the left is another storage room. where we can find 130 credits. Nothing in the back. Really nothing else. That's fine. Here's the staircase up. We'll check that in just a minute, but before we go, let's go over here and hack this level 4 door. We have the code, but of course, like always, I prefer to hack it.
Access granted.
Waited on the data store, which had a stop worm, then I nuked the exit node up for 100 XP. Now, as I head into the room, I get a 200 XP explorer bonus. Over on this, looks like a little folding table, there's a hypostim. On the cabinets next to the bed, there's a second hypostim. Next to the computer, well, I guess we'll read the computer first. From Hiren Alpha at Panchaea.consortium.net, the Sex Center Command at Panchaea.consortium.net, emergency lockdown protocols. This is an automatically generated message from the Panchaea Oceanic Installation 5 Hiren Core. In accordance with Command String Protocol 00066 Full Station Alert, we/us have initiated emergency lockdown protocols. The following commands will be in effect until Command String Protocol 00067 Cancel Alert is activated. Protocol 000661, activate emergency alert system, all levels. Protocol 000662, secure Class A control centers/rooms, all levels. Protocol 000663, lock dedicated security terminals, all levels. Protocol 000664, activate auto laser protection protocols, all levels. Protocol 000665, activate auto robot patrol protocols, all levels. Protocol 000666, prepare for full purge and breakdown, the promised land awaits. From Sharon Jacobs at Panchaea.consortium.net to Russell Simons at Panchaea.consortium.net. Login and password? Hey Russ, can you tell me if the login and password info I have for Sex Station XXX is correct? I think it's this. Login Amelie, password last forever. P.S. I know I should just ask the network, but you know how those automated messages creep me out. Anyway, next to the computer is a nuke virus. And then behind these boxes, we find a vent. Let's head through it. Behind the storage room. And into another barracks, behind the disabled door from earlier. Another 200 XP explorer bonus. On the bed is a combat rifle ammo. Leaning against the wall is a heavy rifle. And in the corner is a heavy rifle, plasma rifle, cooling system, weapon mod. So there we go. Let's loop back out of here and head up the stairs. This dead body has nothing. Move up the stairs. Nothing to the right, so let's turn left. We have a level 4 locked room here, so let's hack it open. I cannot get to the server node. There is only one data store. Which I feel free to get at my leisure. Especially now that I'm already adjacent to the exit node.
Access
so a nuke
granted.
Virus and 100 XP for the hack. Let's check this room out. Inside we find nothing on the first shelves. Nothing on the second shelves. Nothing under any of the boxes. On the desk we find two plasma capsules and a level 4 locked security hub. So let's hack it open. Cannot get to the server node. There are two exit nodes, but only one data store.
Access Access granted.
And there we go. 400 XP from the data store plus 100 for the hack. We find there is another disabled camera next to the turret. And we could turn off the turret, but I'd rather just go handle it. So, this first dead body has nothing. Let's just wait for the turret to pan away from us. I want to get close to it and take it out with the typhoon. So I think I can do that without any repercussions. And it's just... yeah, there's the only camera we might accidentally destroy. Oh, now that we've taken out the turret, let me search the dead bodies. Nothing. 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 We find that door is disabled, and as soon as we hop through this window, we're going to trigger a cutscene, after which we'll learn if our stealth bonus has stayed intact, and then we get into the game's final social battle. So, let me save and head through there.
I don't think you want to do that, Mr. Jensen. Disengage lockdown, and whatever demons this station contains are likely to come crashing out on us.
Afraid to die, Darrow? Or just unwilling to face what you've done?
Oh, I know what I've done, believe me. I take no pleasure in it.
And yet you still did it.
I did what had to be done. 20 years ago, I gave the world augmentation technology. I thought I was giving it a bright future, but instead I gave it the means to destroy itself. No law, no UN regulation was going to fix that.
People are dying out there. Hundreds of thousands of people driven to the brink of insanity because of you.
I had to convince the world. Before today, people believed we should steal fire from the gods and redesign human nature. Human nature is the only thing we have that gives us a moral compass and the social skills we need to live in peace. Destroy it, and you destroy our very species.
Don't paint yourself a savior in this. What you're doing is insane.
Is it? When this is done, the Illuminati won't be able to control men and women like you as they had planned, from the inside out. No one will be able to use the technology I invented to make others into beings they desire. Something we both know has happened already.
You think you're Frankenstein? Killing his own monster?
Actually, Mr. Jensen, I prefer to think of myself as Daedalus, watching helplessly as his child crashes into the sea.
I'm ending this. No.
All right. Excellent. We got the 500 XP getting things done, 500 XP ghost, 250 XP smooth operator. So, here comes the game's last social battle.
Ow.
You can't. The signal is being generated from the broadcast center at the base of this facility.
Personality traits: perceptive, confident, pragmatic. Psychological profile: tends to dismiss other people and viewpoints, creating an emotional wall behind which he retreats.
Panchaea's security system has been programmed to protect it.
Views himself as an educator of lesser people, may be destabilized if his arguments are proven wrong.
And will kill you before you even get close.
Can easily convert people to his cause, is not used to resistance.
You designed that system, Darrow. You can tell me how to shut it down.
But I won't. You think what I'm doing is extreme. You simply don't understand. For humanity to survive beyond this century, it must abandon ill-conceived notions about transcendence and embrace change. But for that to happen, the hard lesson must be learned. Blood must be shed.
I'm going to critique first.
What you're doing is horrific. It has to stop. You can't force people to change. They have to do it on their own, or they'll end up resenting you for it. And doing it like this? My God, Darrow, it's insane.
It is not insane, Mr. Jensen. Tragic, yes. Unavoidable? No. History has shown us again and again that the human race is hidebound and governed by inertia. As a society, as a species, the only way to elicit any kind of reaction from it is through an act of tragedy, a horrible cataclysm. I regret what I have been forced to do, but given what I know about mankind and the dangers facing us, this was the only viable choice.
I'm gonna appeal.
You want us to see what you see? Fine. Our humanity is threatened because technology is messing with our minds. But how can we recognize this message when we're grieving over the people you forced us to leave behind? Friends and neighbors, people we care about. Is the image of their murders the vision you want us to have?
Of course it isn't. I don't want to be remembered as a monster. It was my genius that created the technology. My vision that seduced Sarif and Zhao and all the others who now feed off of it. They seek to stand on the shoulders of my research without comprehending the danger that people like you pose to mankind. I am the only one with the perspective, the insight, to know what is needed.
Let's appeal again.
People like me? I'm no different than you, Darrow. I'm still a human being, just like all the men and women you're driving insane out there. Step back for just one moment and see it through our eyes. You've convinced yourself you're saving the world, but you're just lashing out in spite.
Lashing out in spite? Spare me your pathetic attempts at schoolboy psychology. You do not understand me. No one does. All of this is academic, Mr. Jensen. As long as this technology exists, men like you and me will still crave it, still do anything to have it, despite the cost to our bodies and souls. Well, today, I have set the dominoes falling to change that. I have altered the course of human history for a second time. And this time, it is setting things right.
Let's extrapolate.
You can't have the future, so no one can, is that it? Open your eyes, Darrow. Look at what your obsession is doing to the world. When all of this is over, nothing will be left but anarchy and fear, smoldering in the ashes of burning cities. How can anything be rebuilt from that?
No, that's not what I wanted. There must be something left, some hope of renewal. Because without hope, there is nothing. I will give you what you want, Mr. Jensen. Codes to shut down Panchaea's security system. But you'll still be in danger. Much of the system is self-determining and lethal. When you see it, maybe then you'll understand. The technology I created will not be the future any one of us desires. Please, help the world understand that.
Good. 1,000 XP, Silver Tongue. Achievement unlocked to the final countdown. Pocket Secretary added to Media Log. New goal. So, first, the achievement. The final countdown. You pointed out the flaws in his logic to millionaire Hugh Darrow. You've earned 42 out of 49 achievements, 85%. Here's the pocket secretary. SECREQ000001 Hiren Core Access. From Hiren Alpha at Panchaea.consortium.net to Father D at Omega.di.net. This is an automatically generated message from the Panchaea Oceanic Installation 5 Hiren Core. We/us have received your request for personal security override code for drone.hiren.core/all. The dedicated terminal's shutdown protocol input configuration has now been preset for 2012. Hello, Father. And goals. Reach the broadcast center. Darrow's signal is being generated from the base of the station. Now that lockdown's disengaged, I need to descend through the station until I reach the broadcast center. So, let me make a new permasave, just because I got the, the stealth bonuses. And let's talk to Darrow.
The code should help you shut down the Hiren Project, Panchaea's security system. When you see it, you will understand. There is no room for this technology in the world. Do not let me keep you. Use the codes and shut down the signal. When you do, the fate of the world will be in your hands. Do not let me keep you.
All right.
Use the codes and shut down the signal. When you do, the fate of the world will be in your hands.
There's an e-book on the podium. The speech. Mr. Secretary General, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, David Seraph has asked me to assemble you here today so that we might speak openly and honestly about a global issue, an issue which even now threatens to pull our society apart. I am speaking, of course, of human enhancement technology, the merging of man and machine. Contrary to popular opinion, I did not come up with the concept, but 20 years ago I embraced it with all my heart and soul, for I believed that blending technology with human biology would enable us to reach a level of achievement which only gods can achieve. I saw us living as gods in a realm without illness, suffering, or death, a realm in which every individual is able to become the man that biology, society, circumstance, or fate has tried so desperately to keep him from becoming. I myself hoped to be one of those men. 20 years later, I can say with certainty that this dream I had is tarnished. Human enhancement technology has not turned us into gods. Instead, it has opened the door once again for powerful men to believe they have the right to make others what they please. Men want control of the future, of the world, of each other. David asked me to show the world how human enhancement technology can change it, and after careful deliberation, I've realized I must do exactly that. I know that many of you will condemn me after today, but I also believe that one day I will be remembered as the man who saved humanity. David, forgive me. Alright, let's search these bodies. I don't think any of them have anything. Nothing on that one, nothing on that one. Over here, on the top level, there's nothing. This one has nothing. Over here, on the top level, there's also nothing. Let's go down one level, then. This body has nothing. Seems to be nothing over here. This body has nothing. Nothing here either, so let's head back down. Nothing over here, nothing in this room. You will notice.
Richard, the lockdown's disengaged. I'm heading back to the hangar to see if those blast doors are open. Have you been able to raise anyone?
I'm picking up several glimmers, but there's too much interference. I think you're on your own, Jensen.
Careful there, Francis. You almost sound like you regret that.
All right, let's keep going. You can see the mess of people down here, but they aren't worth any combat experience, so all I really want to do is sneak past them. Keep my stealth bonuses going.
Just leave me alone, all of you.
Come on,
leave me alone.
cloak up and keep creeping along. Cloak again. Get in the elevator. Ride it back down to the entry hall. Opening the elevator alarmed one of the guys, but that doesn't really matter. Oh, we've got a whole new legion now that have appeared in the entry hall. But it's still as simple as sneaking past all of them. Although, admittedly, crossing the room can be a little more complicated now. But it's still not that bad. Just cloak up and cross.
Intruder! I'm here! Seeing shadows. Oh, they're just shadows.
I can't control them anymore! Run! Run! Fuck you! Fuck you! I hate you, monster!
Anyway, you can see all of them here. Just gonna wait for my energy cell to recharge. Then I'm actually gonna dart into this vent and try to move past them this way.
Go away, Ghost! Go away! You don't scare me!
I can't control them anymore!
Need to get through those doors, so let's cloak up and do it. I'm gonna shut the doors behind me, leave those people safely behind. Okay. Whoa. Well, somebody saw me through the door, which I didn't think could happen. So I'll be sure to dodge into the side room a little bit more quickly. Anyway, the dead body has nothing on it. Let's hop in here. We can't get through there. That's not a big issue. We've got one crazy walking around out here, looks like. But I don't know exactly where they are, so let me just search this room. We've got a box of heavy rifle ammo and a box of combat rifle ammo in the locker on the left. The locker on the right has sniper rifle ammo. Nothing on these desks or under these desks. Over here, there's nothing except the unlocked computer, so let's check it out. From Chantel Fournier at Panchaea.consortium.net to Henry Godot at Panchaea.consortium.net. Attitude problem. I can't believe you said that at lunch today, Henry. Global warming is no joke. Most of the people in this station came here because we know our planet is in imminent danger and it's our responsibility to do something about it. Did you know that over 70% of our world is covered by water? 97% of that water is in our oceans. Life on Earth began in the ocean 3.1 to 3.4 billion years ago, and then evolved from the ocean to the land millions of years ago. The oceans provide most of the oxygen we need to breathe, and a reservoir for soaking up almost half of this planet's carbon pollutants. In other words, for every human, animal, and plant on Earth, a healthy ocean is a must. Darrow knows that. That's why he came up with the whole iron seeding plan, to restore health back into our oceans and give mankind a chance to survive. We've spent years abusing this planet, and most of the people working here believe it's our responsibility to clean up that mess and make the planet safe and livable for future generations. Maybe you came here because you got a nice paycheck and some really cool augmentations you would never have been able to afford otherwise, but the rest of us didn't. So in the future, please keep your snide comments to yourself, Chantel. From engineering at panchaea.consortium.net to Henry Godot at panchaea.consortium.net. Reply, I got a safety hazard here, guys. I already told you, Hank, for the time being, just keep people away from the turbine area. We know the air shaft's not finished, and we realize that the vortex created by the airflow is a safety hazard, but it's not the only one we're dealing with right now. I'll try to get someone from engineering over there ASAP, but don't hold your breath on it, all right? Henry Godot at Panchaea.consortium.net wrote, Hey JC, when are you guys going to finish that damn air vent? Don't you know you're holding old Darrow back from saving the world? Global warming isn't going to fix itself, you know. Hank. Anyway, let's head back out this door. Right here we find ourselves on the other side of that blast door, which we still couldn't open. But let's keep moving. As I come over here, I see to this locker room, I see one crazy moving around. Must be back in the last row. Somewhere. There he is. Give him a non-lethal takedown, since he's all by himself. Then we can start searching these lockers. He's got nothing. On the bench, we find 80 credits. First row of lockers here. Nothing. 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 And nothing. Middle row of lockers. Well, I guess I should say second row. Nothing. Nothing. Painkillers. Nothing. 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 Combat rifle ammo. Third row. Nothing. 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 Nuke virus. Nothing. Nothing. And nothing. Firewall. Nothing. Plasma capsules. Nothing. 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 Stopworm. 110 credits. And nothing. Alright. Let's keep going then. See here, a limb clinic to the left. This dead body has nothing, but let's head over to the limb clinic before we do anything else. Need to be able to move this vending machine to get into the game's final limb clinic. Now that we're in here, we see a living person. Let's search the rest of the room first. Nothing on the dead body, but there's an ebook on the table. Mech Style, Augmentation Couture and Cutting-Edge Cyberware for the Enhanced Human. The United Nations Biopolitic Vote, What It Means for You. Tai Young Medical's new BX series cyber limbs. Are the rumors of a 45% failure rate true? New enhancements for the Hermes cyber leg prosthesis. Full body conversions in the next decade. Top 5 mech style picks. Implanted cellular phones and digital media players. Limb opens new clinics in Glasgow, Oslo, and Wellington. The rise in black market cybernetics. Can you afford to take the risk? Take a dive. We review the AirSure implanted rebreather device off the coast of Baja. We discuss the aftermath of the recent anti-augmentation riots in Dallas. Behind the scenes with Serif Industries' new dermal sheath process. On the slopes with the Aug borders of Aspen. Looking to the future. Where do we go next? The facts about nanotechnology. Anyway, I see a credit chip next to the couch. 250 credits. A pocket secretary on the couch. SECREQ000211 from Hiron Alpha at Panchaea.consortium.net to JP Chevalier at Panchaea.consortium.net. This is an automatically generated message from the Panchaea Oceanic Installation 5 Hiron Core. We/us have received your request for new security access codes for sec.hub.109/drone.c.hironl. The new login will be HUALALING. The new password will be I want love. See the wind, turn the rudder. There is nothing else out here except a computer, which is unlocked. From Lim Corporate to Lim Clinic Global, TYM Biochip, attention all doctors. No doubt you have been receiving complaints from a number of patients regarding unusual neuroprosthetic malfunctions lasting between 5 and 30 seconds. The World Health Organization is aware of this problem and is working with us to determine the cause. In the meantime, we have decided to initiate emergency maintenance upgrade procedures of our own. In the next few days, your clinic will be receiving shipments of a new Class A biochip manufactured by the Taiyang Medical Corporation. It is our belief that these chips will eliminate many, if not all, of the malfunctions patients have been experiencing. We strongly urge you to distribute these implants as quickly as possible as part of each patient's routine neuroprosthetic appointment. Study the implant procedure manual closely. Any questions you or your patients have will no doubt be answered in it. And please bear in mind that failure to comply with this directive could severely infringe upon your clinic's ability to solicit future funding. Sincerely, Compliance Team. Finally, let's talk to the doctor.
You seem relatively normal, Nishvar.
All things considered, yeah. You okay?
Thankfully, I was able to barricade myself in here when things got out of control. So, is it safe to come out now?
No. The rest of the station is still under siege. You better stay here until help comes. In the meantime, is it possible to download Praxis software here?
Yes, of course. No damage was done to the computers. See for yourself.
Yes. So, let's buy 2 hypo stims, 2 cyber boost. Oh, I can't fit a cyber boost pro energy jar. All right. Now let's buy all the typhoon ammo I can. Now my inventory's full. That's fine. I don't really need anything else.
I will remain here where it's safe. If you need help or get word of help, please come back.
Anyway, we bought 2 Praxis kits. Let's go ahead and use them. We'll get Mark and Track 3.0 with one of them, which will finish off the Stealth Enhancer. And let's get my second-to-last augmentation, Detection Feedback in the Hacking Analyze add-on. Only one more left, only 1,320 XP away from it. Let's keep going for now. Nothing on that body.
This is William Taggart. If anyone out there is listening, I'm begging you, help. We've barricaded ourselves inside the core server room. Many of us are wounded. Please, save us. Please, save us.
Find and speak with Taggart. It's a secondary objective, but apparently Bill Taggart is trapped inside this station, barricaded with several wounded colleagues inside a server room. I should probably find him and see what he has to say. There's not really anything else in this hallway, which is fine. We're coming up on some crazies, though. Can head out to the ring section here, and, well, looks like I don't really have a choice. There's nowhere else to go. So, none of these dead bodies have been having anything. I doubt they're about to suddenly start. That one's got nothing. Boy, there are 2 levels to the section we're on. I don't want to take these guys down. There's no reason to. Just need to get past them. Of course, we have here a storage room that I want to hack open. I wonder. Maybe I can finally use one of my gas grenades. Well, no, I don't think Ghost will stay intact through that.
Let me go! Ah, get away!
Ow. Be quiet! I can't think with
I was hopeful that if I got the one guy who was patrolling, I'd be safely able to hack, and that might actually still be true. Let me see if I can just...
Something's in the shadow.
I'd like to just pull the one patroller out a little bit farther. If everybody else just stays where they are, I should be able to hack it with minimal trouble.
Rats. Seeing shadows. Oh, they're just shadows. Choking me. Get away!
Okay. Well, he's got nothing on him. He's fine. Let's drag his body out where the others won't spot it. And since the others all appear stationary, now I think I could probably perform this hack without any trouble. Just leave him here where that dead body is. Let's hack this thing open now. Now I think I can get away with it. Can't get to the server node, and there are two data stores. Let's make sure we get both of them.
Access granted.
75 XP in the data store, stop worm in the data store, 75 XP for the hack. Now the door's unlocked. Nobody saw us, which is good. Let's head into here and see what we find. A shotgun and a gas grenade. My inventory is completely full, which is great. Okay. I don't think... Okay, let me take down the other patroller. Just lure him over here.
They're closing in on me. The shadows. See them everywhere. The pipes! He wants the pipes again! Freaking me!
I know.
Kinda gotta watch for the key guys, the ones that are patrolling. He's got nothing. Let's drag him sort of away from the cluster the others have formed. All right. Well, there's plenty going on here. We need to check the other levels out here out, but let's see what's through the what, if anything, is through these doors. Nothing. That's nothing but a cluster of workers. Okay, that's good. Actually, maybe I should just go ahead and see what is through this other door on the top level before I head down. So, let me see what I can find back here. Ah, the server room. Okay, I think we're making our way to Taggart, but maybe I should make sure I've checked everything out here first. Just a moment, viewer. Alright, viewers, sorry for another hiccup. Let's head over to that staircase we had spotted. And head down and check out the next level down. All right. Well, we've got our next cluster of crazies here. We've got one facing this way, ish. Well, not really, so. We can just cross into this open room. Two boxes of heavy rifle ammo, a shotgun and shotgun cartridges, an automatic unlocking device, and a box of combat rifle ammo. That's handy. Let's explore this direction first. There's a security bot in there, an inactive one, and I believe this is what we've been saving. This is what the real reason we acquired the heavy rifle. These bots aren't tied to any security hubs, if I remember right, which means that we have to just destroy them with the laser rifle, which I think we can do through the walls, which is pretty cool. But before I do that, let's hack open this other storage room here on the middle level. I cannot get to the server node. There are two data stores. Credits, a nuke virus,
access granted.
And 75 XP for the hack. Alright, let's search the storage room. There's a plasma rifle, heavy rifle ammo, 4 plasma capsules. Alright, let's head over here. See what I can find. Nothing except a lone dead body that's carrying nothing. Alright, let's see about that bot now. Somebody on the lowest, on the lower level heard me. That's what that was. Alright. Let's get out the laser rifle. Let's turn on smart vision. Alright, we're gonna have to be more careful than that. Maybe we'll destroy it through the, from inside the storage room. That sounds better. Or maybe we just make sure it can't see us. Or maybe I do need to take down all these crazies first. I was thinking we could leave them alone, but maybe we do need to systematically take them all down. That's fine. Let's finish exploring these areas first. I can't afford to. I don't like seeing that hostile tag. Not when there are ghost bonuses at stake.
It's happening! Show yourself! Who are you?
I think the good news, as far as I can tell, is that I can seemingly pull a lot of them away, but before I worry too much about it, let's first just see what's over here.
Go!
No! You don't get me! What are you doing?
Well, shoot. Alright, well, there is a storage room to explore, plus another open room behind them. And it seems like the only real way to get it explored is actually gonna be to take these guys down. So,
oh,
I don't think that's gonna work.
Hey!
Yeah, someone's gonna hear that.
You're the monster! It's your fault!
Fuck you! Fuck you! I hate you, monster!
No, no, there's no one here. It's all in your head. All in your
head. This can't go on! I can't take much more of this!
No, 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 no!
Must have been the wind. That? Oh, that was... Please, let it be nothing.
I did finally use a Cyber Boost Pro Energy Bar to accomplish that takedown. Let's just drag him over here. Leave him here. Now I can... I'm hopeful that I can do a double. But I guess not. It doesn't matter much. Let's just pull the back one a little farther out with a jump. Right here should be good.
Just leave me alone. No, no, there's no one here. It's all in your head. All in your head.
I had to. They would have done it to me, but I did it first.
Just leave me alone. Alone, all of you.
Well, I already know this isn't going to work. Nope.
No, there's no...
Who are you? Oops. Oops, oops, oops. That actually seems good if I can just... get to cover in time.
No, no, there's no one here. It's all in your head. All in your head. You had to do it! It was them or you!
Ow! Oh!
All right. There's another one. That wasn't too bad. Let's pull him away from the cluster. There's another one facing this way. I'll go ahead and try and pull him out and then deal with him. He's got nothing. Drag him away from the group. Let's get back in there. See if we can take down this one.
Hey! Hey!
Nope. It's okay, it just means we need to back up a little and jump to pull him out.
Hey! Hey! Hello! Is anyone there? Huh? Is there?
No.
Alright, that one's got nothing. Let's pull him away. And just keep working. There are a lot of these guys. Let's do a jump right here. That one's got nothing. Oh, this is tedious. I didn't think they'd go hostile when I blew up the robot, but lo and behold, they do. Just gotta pull them out one at a time. And then drag the bodies away. I know it's tedious, folks, and I apologize. But it seems like the only way to blow the robot Let's just pull another one out. Same process. That one's got nothing. Pull another one. Keep on working. That one's got nothing. I think I can actually probably do a double on these two. But the others might hear it, which is the problem. We'll find out. Oh good, they didn't.
Is anybody there? Can you hear me? I've got survivors here. We've locked ourselves in a machine room. Please! Help us!
Okay. So, new secondary goal. Find and speak with Seraph. Sounds like a group of survivors have locked themselves in a machine room. David Seraph is one of them. Maybe I should find him and ask him a few questions. Anyway, let's search the other one. He's got nothing. Now we should be able to do a double on these guys. Well, I guess we can't quite. Well, hopefully they're far enough away from each other that I can just do takedowns, but oh good, they are. Alright, that one's got nothing, which is no surprise. It seems like most of them end up having nothing. Wait for the energy cell to recharge. Knock him out. Alright, well, this mid-level is clear. There's still plenty on the top level and on the bottom, and I think all three levels have been hearing me. Anyway, now that this is clear at least, let's check out this storeroom. We've got 95 credits, shotgun cartridges, and it looks like not much else. Anyway, I'll go deal with the chore of... Well, let me see where the guys on each level are, just so I can properly identify them. Okay, well, it looks like there is nobody here on the bottom level. This level has that big drop, although there is a ladder of sorts. It doesn't look like Jensen can climb it. Okay, if there isn't anyone down here, then it means it was the guys on the top level who were alerted to my robot shenanigans. Anyway, is there a way back up from this bottom level? Yes. Alright, let's search around down here, too. If I remember correctly, it's that circular shaft in the middle that ultimately leads us toward the end of the level. So, let's get back up to the top level and deal with those crazies so we can safely attack the robot. It's an exercise in tedium, but we do what we must. Alright. Well, here's the first guy.
No, not me.
No.
Yeah, I didn't think that was gonna be as clean as I'd like. Wonder if I can do a double on these guys. I doubt it. They're not quite close enough together. No. That's fine. Let's just pull one of them with sound.
No. There's no one.
Then we'll get the other one. Alright, there's one. Let's drag him away. Now we'll wait for the recharge, and then we will get this one. Looks like they're hallucinating spiders, and I have to say, I sympathize. If I were hallucinating spiders, I'd probably go pretty crazy too. Alright. Let's bag that one. Can do that without any real repercussions, which is nice. Let's drag his body away. Wait for the cell to recharge. See if maybe I can do a double on these guys. Can. Good. Oh. I can do a double on those guys, but somebody else is going to see me, apparently. So I need to stay crouched. To be just a little more careful. All right. Let's haul that one over. And search him. Looks like we've got four guys left. He's got nothing. Let's search the other one and then move him. He's got nothing either, which is fine. Hey, let me go. drag him over here with all of his friends. All right, now let's loop around and get the guy who spotted me. Although I think I'm gonna get one other guy first.
I know.
We're okay with that one. He's got nothing. I see three workers left up here. Let's just wait for my energy cell to recharge. Alright, let's take this one down. That leaves two. Don't really see anything on the first one. Get this one first. Think we'll be okay. Just pull him a little ways away. We don't have to worry as much. Because there is only one crazed worker left. Wait for the recharge to finish. I don't think he has anything either. What I can do is... Alright, there really is nothing in there, which is fine. Oh no. I was worried for a second Jensen was going to take the big dive. I wasn't ready for that. Alright. Now let's blow this robot, and hopefully nobody else will get upset. No. We're good. Okay. There's nothing inside the security station. Let's head back up to the top level now and go to the server room. This is where Taggart said he was holed up. Oh, here we are. There's a camera panning around. Two cameras panning around down here. And plenty more crazy workers. Let me just open this door and see what I find. Combat rifle ammo. There's a pocket secretary on that dead body. SECREQ219900 from HyronAlpha@Panchaea.consortium.net to Uwe.Bakey@Panchaea.consortium.net. This is an automatically generated message from the Panchaea Oceanic Installation 5 Hyron Core. We/us have received your request for new security access codes for sec.hub.433/acc.cam.all. The new login will be Kathy's. The new password will be missing home. Live, love, learn. This body has nothing. Here is the security hub. Let's hack it open.
I don't want it.
Level 5. We can't get the server node, and it's got... Alright, we're just gonna nuke everything. Except the last exit node, of course. So we got 400 credits in the stop worm from the data stores.
Access granted.
125 XP for the hack. We can turn off all of the cameras. And there's a security bot somewhere, which is inactive. That's fine. Before I do too much of anything else, let's just see what's back here. The dead body had nothing. Let's see about the other one. It also has nothing. And there's nothing else there besides the cluster of workers. So hopefully we don't have to mess with them beyond sneaking around. Now that the cameras are off, we should be able to stay out here and not worry too much. I'm just trying to make sure there are no goodies down here, and it looks like there actually aren't. There are a couple of heavy crates there. Here is the security bot station. Nothing on that body, nothing on that body, but there is a pocket secretary. SECREQ000210 from Hyron Alpha at Panchaea.consortium.net to Helmet.Deer at Panchaea.consortium.net. This is an automatically generated message from the Panchaea Oceanic Installation 5 Hyron Core. We/us have received your request for new security access codes for SEC.hub.109/drone.a.hyron. The new login will be Marilyn. The new password will be YYYYYYY. Give me wings to fly so I might soar. And here we have the bot. So let's do this the old-fashioned way. Let me just stick an EMP mine in front of the station. Then I'll go back to the security hub and turn the robot on. And then the moment of truth will be whether or not that aggravates these crazy workers. Let me disconnect. Quick save. Activate the robot. Looks like everything's fine. That's what I was hoping for. Now let's cloak up and get back out of here. Alright. Bot has been dealt with. Now, let's move these crates. There is the server room. If we had moved past the workers. So let's search these bodies. The soldier has 5 plasma capsules. Nothing on these boxes. That one's got nothing. That one's got nothing. That one's got nothing. That one's got a laser rifle battery. Oh, let's hack this door. For which we have found no code, but we can get to the server node. That makes things nice and easy.
Access granted.
500 credits plus 125 XP. Now let's open the door, where we find the man himself, Bill Taggart, along with his entourage. So let's talk to everyone else first.
How did you manage to avoid being affected by the signal? Were you in on it with that bastard, Darrow? Now the governments of the world will finally realize that every one of you should be shut down and disassembled. This technology needs to be shoved back in its box. Now the governments of the world will finally realize that every one
on
of
the
you
desk, we've got 250 credits. On the desk, we have a laser rifle battery and a nuke virus.
Get away! Just get away! I saw what you people did. You killed them all! You even killed each other! It was a massacre! People were pleading on their knees, crying for mercy! And they were all murdered by you augmented monsters! Just go! It was a massacre! People were pleading on their knees, crying for mercy! And they were all murdered by you augmented monsters! Just go!
That Hugh Darrow is a monster! Such a tragedy. In the right hands, this technology could have helped so many people. If I hadn't made up my mind long ago, this would prove to me that augmentation technology should be under strict controls. If I hadn't made up my mind long ago, this would prove to me that augmentation technology should be under strict controls.
You seem to be unaffected by the signal that Darrow is broadcasting. I suppose that is a military adaptation. We've dabbled in something we shouldn't have. And look at the result. We've dabbled in something we shouldn't have. And look at the result.
All right, let's check this unlocked computer. We've seen that. From Core Center Command at Panchaea.consortium.net to Sex Center Command at Panchaea.consortium.net. Taking care of our girls. Look, guys, I know it makes some of you squeamish, but we have a responsibility to these girls. They are sacrificing everything to make sure this station is safe and secure. Need I remind you what could happen if one tiny crack in the outer structure goes undetected? I'm not asking you to sit in there and talk to them, but I am asking you to make sure the nutrient lines are filled and no contaminants are getting in, and it's perfectly safe to open the pod every once in a while to check for heart rate and pulse fluctuations manually. Just remember to use the associated security hub for each pod to open, and then close it after you're done. Thanks, ST. Okay. Anyway, let's just look out over that room. That's neat looking. And finally, let's talk to Taggart.
Mr. Jensen. How ironic that you should be the one to save us from the monsters out there.
Monsters, Taggart? You mean people. Augmented people who've lost all control, lost their reason.
Isn't that supposed to be my line? Unfortunately, it seems your esteemed Mr. Darrow decided to appropriate my point and turn it back on me. In madness and in blood. He has betrayed us all.
So you finally admit it. You are part of this, after all. You have been all along.
It would be pointless to deny anything now, but despite what you think of us, we never wanted augmentations outlawed. All we've ever sought is regulation, rules governing how the technology is developed, and laws that ensure it's used for the good of society.
You've raised society above humanity. So who gets to make those rules?
Men with wisdom, strength, and tenacity to know what's right. Proven leaders who distinguish themselves, like you, Mr. Jensen. You've certainly earned the right to be one of us. All you have to do is take it.
I'm not looking for glory, Taggart.
Just remember that without control, there's no room for freedom, only anarchy. You were a policeman once. You know the importance of order.
I know there's a difference between order and slavery.
The biochip wasn't supposed to force people to do anything. It merely limited power so that people couldn't go on killing sprees like the ones taking place right now.
Amazing how well that worked out.
Say what you will. But I know that some part of you agrees with me. Absolute freedom is no different than absolute chaos. Society needs boundaries if it has any hope of surviving. And you, Mr. Jensen, can be the one to give us that hope. Shut down Darrow's signal. Then help me get a message out saying that an accident at VersaLife contaminated the world's neuropazine supply.
VersaLife? And what if I decided to blame the Illuminati?
The Illuminati is just a name to get rich financiers to invest more money. Besides, do you really think the world will believe in some 18th century conspiracy theory? Do this for us, and you'll ensure a future for mankind, all of mankind, augmented or otherwise. The future Hugh Darrow offers doesn't allow for both.
Let me think about it.
Find and speak with Taggart. 500 XP.
All of this is as much your fault as it is Darrow's. You and your cabal.
Perhaps. But all we sought was a safety valve, Mr. Jensen. A means of making sure the world would never spin out of control. The potential of this technology is great, but as we've seen, its potential for destruction is even greater.
Your doomsday scenario doesn't impress me. You'd say anything to stay in power.
Do you think humanity will simply police itself? We do not live in some Eden, Mr. Jensen. Or are you that much like your boss, David Seraph, who envisions a world where everyone is enhanced and suddenly they all love each other? There will always be a need for methods of control.
And conveniently, in your future, the Illuminati will hold the reins.
Not directly. There are organizations already in place that are better equipped to handle certain things. The UN, for instance.
Reimagined, no doubt.
At least somewhat. And this technology will be a great part of it. Imagine, Mr. Jensen, a world governed by common principles. The end to international power struggles, to terrorism. These things can be accomplished if you join us. Stop the signal broadcast and get the word out, Mr. Jensen. Remember, Darrow's vision would set us back for centuries. There will always be a need for boundaries. Without them, society collapses. There will always be a need for boundaries. Without them, society...
All right, that's it for that. So, let's go down to the mid-level now. Head toward the machine room where we can find David Seraph. Oh, dang. I was hoping to land on the middle level. That doesn't matter that much. We just have to hike up a ladder. And head over here. No doubt there's another batch of crazies, but doesn't bother me too much. Well, maybe not. What is back here? Well, that goes farther down. So does that elevator. The elevator ostensibly goes to the machine room. I say let's go there manually. Let's take the stairs instead. Oh, never mind. That goes to the broadcast center. We can't have that. I guess we will just take the elevator to the machine room. Down we go. Here comes the next batch of crazies. All right, the machine room is this way. Yes, there is another batch of crazies. Okay, here's a box of heavy rifle ammo.
Get away from me! Get away! Get away from me! Okay. Is it gone? Is it gone? Get up! Get up! Get up! Get up!
I can't control them anymore! Run! Run!
Get away from me! You'll be here! Get away!
You're the monster! It's your fault!
Get up! Get up! Get up! Get up!
If we head through this way, it looks like we can bypass most of the crazies just by hiding under the machines.
Get away from me!
There's a big door into something called Section B. This door leads into a little storage room with some lockers, which I guess I'll check out. First one's empty, second one combat rifle ammo, shotgun cartridges, third one cyber boost pro energy bar, fourth one a pocket secretary. SECREQ000212 from HyrenAlpha@Panchaea.consortium.net to Serge.Moreau@Panchaea.consortium.net. This is an automatically generated message from the Panchaea Oceanic Installation 5 Hyren Core. We/us have received your request for new security access codes for SEC.hub.109/drone.b.hyren. The new login will be Dayu, the new password will be forgotten. The old stable horse still yearns to run. I don't really see anything else in here, so let's move out here, and we find a level 4 locked door. Let's hack this one open. We can get to the server node. Perfect.
Access
200 XP in the data store, 100 XP for the hack. That gives me the last praxis point I need to get the last augmentation. Analyze all data stores. Bam. Everything unlocked. That's a thing of beauty. Anyway, there's another door into this corridor, which I'll need to hack open. As you can see, we're booby-trapped with mines. Let's be careful. There's another big batch of crazies down here, too. And before we go any farther, let's find the way to that other door, because we can hack it. Even though I now have no more need for XP, I'm still gonna try to get it all.
Get away from me! Get away!
These are the wages of thoroughness. Well, this is another room full of crazies. That dead body has nothing.
I know you're not there.
Stop talking to me.
There's a wall we could punch through. I don't really feel like doing that. Just move behind the machines and get around that way, insofar as we can. That looks like hot water, which I should maybe avoid. Oh, no, we're okay. Submachine room.
Who's there?
What's there?
Get away from me!
I can't tell what's real. What's happening? It was just in your head.
All right.
Stay in control.
Before I do too much, let's grab this mine.
Get away from me!
Search these bodies. That one's got nothing. That one's got nothing. That one's got nothing. Here's another hackable door. Let's hack it open right quick. Cannot get to the server node. It shouldn't be too hard to get everything. Especially considering I really don't need to worry about conserving any software anymore.
Access granted.
Stop worm, 100 XP. Here's another mine. Here's where we were. 300 XP. For finding this room. We've got combat rifle ammo, a plasma rifle, 2 plasma capsules, and you can also get into here if you punch through that wall where that one crazy worker was, but Should be obvious, if we punch through on this side, we'll kill the guy. So, let's head back out here instead and make our way toward the sub-machine room. You can see another frag mine over there, so let's be very careful getting over this little barricade. Right. How are we gonna do that? Yeah, simply jumping is enough to trigger it. Maybe if I try my best to stay away. I don't want to alarm all those crazies, but there has got to be a way through here that doesn't involve the mine exploding. Well, we can't get through there this way, anyway. So I guess we'll just leave that mine alone, then. Maybe try and come at it from the other direction. There must be some other way into that room. Something I haven't spotted yet.
It's in my head! I know it is!
Maybe there's another way through this room. Aha! Yeah, of course. There's another exit right over here. So while we're back here, what can we find? So far, I'm not seeing anything. If I head up these stairs, what do I find?
Quiet! I can't speak with all that noise!
There's another body there.
I don't wanna have to do it.
If I head out here, where am I? If I head all the way out here, I'm at the bottom of that drop shaft. How do I get into that room? There's got to be something.
Get off me! Get off! Get off! Get off! Get off! Get away from me! Get away! Get away from me! Don't! Let me go! Don't!
Get away.
There's gotta be... There has to be something I'm missing somewhere. I'm just gonna take a minute to run around and find it. Well, here's what I'm gonna do.
Come out, goddammit! And I promise you... I won't
hurt you. Still. I just want to talk.
Okay. There is a vent that comes in here. Where's the other side of it? That's what I need to figure out. It's over here, like I suspected. Oh, okay. I was looking at the ground, and I needed to be looking up. That's all. And then, if I want to, I can even get the, ...200 XP for finding this vent. Then as we move down, we find ourselves in the room with Seraph. Before I actually talk to him... Well, okay. There really is no way to disable that frag mine. That's what we figured out. Which is fine. Oh, I didn't want that either. Just turn on Run Silent and Cloak and sprint through that room. Then we'll get up here. Then we'll poke around Seraph's actual room. So, we got people to talk to first.
Tell me you're here to rescue us? Oh my god. I had to crawl through the ventilation to avoid the carnage. It was the scariest thing I've ever seen. They were completely out of control, like wild animals. It was the scariest thing I've ever seen.
We've got what looks like a submarine.
Like wild animals.
Plus what looks like just an empty water tank. Inside this locker, we find 800 credits, sniper rifle ammo, laser rifle battery, and two plasma capsules. Down here are two boxes of heavy rifle ammo. Let's talk to this gal.
Why? Why would Hugh Darrow do such a thing? There's nothing to be gained by causing so much pain and terror. All those poor people, they must be so frightened.
Alright. Let's hop over here. We find a Peps energy pack and tranquilizer darts. Let's talk to this guy.
Do I know you? You're Seraph's boy, aren't you? Jensen. Are you here to stop the carnage? Someone needs to take charge here. I can only imagine what's going on around the globe. This is going to be a death blow to the biotech industry. I can only imagine what's going on around the globe.
How could Darrow turn his back on us? This technology was his baby. It was his passion that made me believe in its possibilities. He's ruined it all. The world will turn its back on us. The industry will collapse and the world will be poorer for it. He's ruined it all. The world will turn its back on us. The industry will collapse and the world will be poorer for it.
I was so scared. I heard two of them coming around the corner, tearing at each other. I just dropped to the floor and played dead. One of them ripped the other one's arm off and beat him to death with it. I thought for sure I was going to be next, but he never noticed me. One of them ripped the other one's arm off and beat him to death
with it. Let's check out this unlocked computer. From Henry Godot at Panchaea.consortium.net to engineering at Panchaea.consortium.net. I got a safety hazard here, guys. Hey, JC, when are you guys going to finish that damn air vent? Don't you know you're holding old Darrow back from saving the world? Global warming isn't going to fix itself, you know. Hank. From Core Center Command at Panchaea.consortium.net to engineering at Panchaea.consortium.net. Forward, valve maintenance and security. Hey, Jerry. Mieko was talking to me about this. Apparently they are seriously worried about valve failure. This is kind of scary, considering we're sitting in the middle of the Arctic Ocean. I think a review team is in order. Can you meet this week? ST. Forward message. Guys, although you all know this, I can't stress it enough. We must keep the main outlet valves in pristine condition. To some extent, they are the Achilles heel of the whole operation. If they fail, the entire station is in danger of collapse. Please make sure everyone is up to date on procedure. Mika. From Core Center Command at Panchaea.consortium.net to Sec Center Command at Panchaea.consortium.net. Hiren Core rules. Safety purge protocols. Hiren Core. 1. Use Security Hub A to open Pod 1 door. 2. Approach manually. 3. Perform visual/manual inspection of equipment. Confirm that coolant level readings are at operational levels. Check for crossed wires in nutrient and life support connector rings. Look for breakages in main structure, flaps, and Icarus platform. Ensure that transistor coupling lines are fully locked with no possibility of leakage. 4. Perform visual/manual inspection of drone. Note pallor of flesh on face, hands, and visible skin. Manually check pulse in neck or wrist. 3. Return to Sec Hub 1 and close door. 4. Repeat sequence with Pod 2 using Sec Hub B. 5. Repeat again with pod 3 using setcub C. 6, to access alpha pod, open pods 1, 2, and 3 and leave open for duration of check. Alright, let's talk to Seraph now.
Adam! Oh, thank God you came. I've got wounded here. We'll have to move them first.
We can't move anyone yet. Not until I get to the base of the station and shut down Darrow's broadcast.
What? Why?
The chaos you experienced here? It's everywhere. The Illuminati created a biochip that stops people from using enhanced abilities, and Darrow turned it into a kill switch.
Oh my God, you... We gotta fix this, Adam. If people realize what's happened, if they believe augmentation technology created this chaos, they'll ban human enhancement research forever.
And that would be a bad thing.
Yes, it would! Don't you see what's at stake here? Ever since man first crawled out of that ocean, we've been striving to be more than we are. Augmentation technology is just the latest, greatest step on a very long road. But we've barely scratched the surface of its potential. We can't let fear stop us from continuing.
That's your belief, Seraph. Not everyone shares it.
But you do, Adam. I know it. And if we work together, we can really make a difference. We can improve the lives of everyone, but only if we fix this.
Go on.
We'd have to get a message out after you shut down Hugh's signal. Tell the world, tell them the Humanity Front did this, that their doctors created a virus that only affects augmented people.
You mean lie?
It'll give us time, son. Time to figure out how to destroy the Illuminati's biochips and move on.
And what about the people who've been hurt by this? Don't they deserve the truth?
Adam, if we want the freedom to become more than we are, we can't be blinded by a misguided morality. Some people will be left behind. It's reality. It's evolution, son.
Right. Evolution based on my DNA.
Please, son, you have to stay with me on this.
I'll think about it.
Find and speak with Seraph. Done. Another 500.
You've got no remorse about using me at all, do you?
I never used you, son.
You experimented with my DNA without telling me.
Adam, this is difficult. Listen. Megan came to me with the sample. When she showed me her finding, when we saw the incredible potential of super compatibility...
You just had to share it with the world.
Adam, think about it. Would you have been able to do any of the things you've done without enhancements? Huh? Most people's bodies aren't as accepting of this technology as yours is. Sharing your DNA makes it possible for us to be like you. How can you deny us that chance?
Who said I would deny it? You stole my DNA and lied to me. You didn't give me the choice.
I'm giving it to you now, Adam. Look, I admit it, I haven't done things the best way. But don't punish the world to spite me. Darrow wants us to live in the Dark Ages. The Illuminati wants to limit evolution to those they control. You and me, we...
Don't group me with you, Seraph. I'll make my own choices from here.
I believe that, son. And I believe you'll make the right ones.
I know blaming Humanity Front leaves a sour taste in your mouth, but it's the only way out of this. So go. The longer that signal broadcasts, the harder it'll be to convince people. Think of it, son. A world where we determine our own path, where there's no limits to human achievement? How can you not want that? Think of it, son. A world where we determine our own
gas grenade.
Where there's no limits to human achievement?
All right. Now let's head toward the broadcast center. We've got things just about wrapped up. Of course, we still gotta get past all these crazies, but that's not really a problem, I don't think. Oh, except I'm going the wrong way. I have to get back through them. So, turn on move silent and cloak and sprint across the room. Turn them back off. Go back to moving slow. get past this next group the same way. Well, actually, it's even a little easier with them.
Get away from me.
We can just creep behind these machines.
You're the monster! It's your fault!
Head all the way over here and then head up the elevator we initially came down. Ride it back up. Now let's head over here toward the broadcast center. Do another quick save here. Not really seeing much along the way. We've got a heavy rifle, two boxes of heavy rifle ammo. As you can see, there's a bunch of gas in that room. We need the implanted rebreather aug to get in here safely. Once we are in here, you find inside the locker an automatic unlocking device and a gas grenade. On the table, 270 credits. And over here, a security hub to hack. Security rating 4. Let's hack this one open. It's got one data store and two exit nodes. We've actually seen this grid before. XP in the data store, plus 100 for the hack. No camera, but there are a couple of turrets we can turn on. I'll turn them on default. Alright, well, it looks like I might have to deal with this last set of crazies if I want to take down those ceiling turrets. Let's at least pull this patroller over.
Come out. I have to find you. I was told to find you.
Well, there's one. Actually, I tell you what I want to do. Since everybody's out on that bridge, I'm going to turn the turret back off so I can deal with the crazies. And then I'll turn it on and destroy it for the experience. Anyway, disable the turrets for now and worry about the crazies. Well, I need to. Need to pull at least that one guy away from that pair.
Come out! I have to find you! I was told to find you!
Let's take this one down. He's got nothing, which is fine. Let's drag the body out here. Now I should be able to get this pair in a double takedown.
Just leave I'm gonna kill you all! I'm gonna kill you all!
I think I will go ahead and use one bar. Just so I can cloak and get close to them. Let's drag these bodies back here. I highly doubt any of them are carrying anything. But I'll search them anyway, just to be certain. That one's got nothing. This one's got nothing. That's all well and good. Alright, well there's the first cluster. Let's see about the rest. Let's just... Alright, let's just start pulling people out here, one at a time.
They said there were no rats here, but I knew there were.
Doing all this just so I can... deal with the turrets. That may be enough, actually. Let me just see if I can turn at least this first turret on and then disable it using EMP. So if I can, then great. Alright, good. There's one down. Just worry about the other one now. Naturally, it's on there on the other side of this bridge. Alright. I'm just gonna wait for my, energy cell to recharge. All right. Here we are on the other side. Let me see if I can bag this one with an EMP mine. And still end up okay. Maybe that's enough. I hope that's enough. We'll have to see. But, in the meantime... let's head out to this big elevator and ride it down. Once the elevator ride begins, there is no turning back. Are you sure you want to descend now? Yes, I am. Here we are descending into the bottom of Hugh Darrow's hole in the ocean. And I think I'll leave the Hiren Corps in the endings for one last separate video. So, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get to the bottom and quick save and see if I have my stealth bonuses. Then, if I do, great news, I'll permasave and pop back here. This is a very long elevator ride. Okay, it's finally slowing down. Here we are at the broadcast center. Well, let's... I see absolutely no goodies in this room, which is a real shame. Let's just sprint down this hall. We got a heavy rifle here, 40 heavy rifle bullets on the soldier. There's a Cyber Boost Pro Energy Pack, 10 heavy rifle bullets, a plasma rifle, painkillers, 5 plasma capsules. Alright, let me just skip the cutscene. Okay, good. We got ghosts and smooth operator. So, I'm going to reload the quick save, make a brand new permasave with just about all of Panchaea done, except for the Hiren Corps, and say, this has been Let's Play Deus Ex Human Revolution. Next time, we will tackle the Hiren Corps in the very end of the game. Until then, thank you for watching. Bye-bye.